to the, every Sunday, my mother would make a lavish Sunday dinner for about, a dozen people. Mm-hmm. And my brother was going with a girl that was a nurse in the hospital, my older brother. And he brought her every Sunday to dinner. And every Sunday after dinner was over, she'd sit around in the lounge and have not even offered to wash a dish. Hmm. And I said to my brother, I said, if you marry her, she's going to be a lousy housekeeper. And I was right.
Brothers, you said older brother. How many brothers and sisters do you have?
I have two brothers and one sister.
And one was younger,
older. My older brother
was older?
Passed away.
Okay.
But I have my baby brother is 90, and my sister is 92. I'm 97.
And how old is your older brother when he died?
He was 6 years older than I. So he would be 103.
And when did he die? How old?
If he were alive.
No. When did he die? How old was he when he did?
Oh, he died at about 80. He had prostate cancer.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
And he made a mistake of going to Mexico to have it fixed.
Oh.
Hmm. You remember when they were claiming all these miracle cures?
South of the border. Now, what about your mother and father? How long did they live?
They were well along in their 80s, yeah. My father died of a stroke, and I gave my mother and dad a house in California, and I got them to move out to live in this house for a while because a friend of mine owned it and he wanted it housewarmed.
Oh, okay.
And they still had their home out in Harrison, Ohio, just right on the Indiana-Ohio line. And one day, mother called me at the studio, and she said, I broke one of Mr. Brown's cups. And I said, well, I think I know where he bought it. I'll replace it. Don't worry. So after they'd been there a couple of months, I said, Mother, you know, Mr. Brown might sell this house. Oh, he wouldn't sell this lovely home. And then I knew they liked it. She liked it. So I gave them the papers for it. And I gave a year's cruise around the world. And they stopped and visited us in Australia. And it was in Australia. I told you we had two beds for them.
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm.
With flowers on. The next morning I took them their morning tea. And all the flowers were on one twin bed, and they were
in the other. So
that's why I mentioned we wouldn't have any trouble.
Yeah.
And then my father died first, and my mother didn't want to live. Her diagnosis, her reason of death was that malnutrition. She didn't want to eat.
Just didn't eat.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Hmm. A lot of times that's the case. It seems like when one goes, the other one loses the will. Well, let me ask you a question regarding your longevity. You're 97 now, born in 1911. Is that right? So you'll be 98 then this year. What's your birthday?
August the 5th.
August the 5th. You send cards and letters.
I was born 1911. And incidentally, I have a driver's license here that's a little bit different than most of them. If you note here, my birth date is August the 5th, 1911, and it expires August the 5th, 2011. I'll be 100 years old.
So what do you attribute your longevity right now?
Well, I don't drink, I don't smoke, and I don't eat too much. Overeating is one of the biggest problems now in the entire world.
Mm-hmm.
If you go to Walmart, you don't have to go to a circus anymore to see the fat lady and the fat man. It's unbelievable how big people are getting. I don't know how they fit in an automobile.
Oh, particularly in the U.S. I believe that's true. More.
know before all else. All confidence games are aimed at people who want something for nothing. Find out who they are, and your fortune is made. If, and here's the second rule of the game, gentlemen, if your hand is quicker than any eye. Now draw a bit closer, gents, and keep your attention on my two hands. My two lily white hands. Nothing up my sleeve, in fact, no sleeves to have anything up. I have here 52 innocent-looking pieces of pasteboard. I select three of them. The king of spades, the king of clubs, and the ace of hearts. But I forgot, gentlemen, I forgot the spice of our little game, the $100 bill. My ill-gotten gains, which you so rightfully took from me.
And which we'll keep it.
Very well, we'll use another one. One which even now reposes behind my shell like ear.
I thought you cleaned them.
Well, I guess it should have worked behind his ears.
Oh, don't blame my friend here. Being an honest man, he didn't look for tricks. Now, your attention, please, gents. The game is simple. The reward is great. I place these three cards face downward on the board. And the man who is sharp enough to guess which card is the ace of hearts receives as his reward this beautifully engraved memento.
Ah, filthy lucre. What crimes are committed in thy name?
And now, gentlemen, for rule three. A little hocus-pocus known as hypnotizing the suspect. By which, of course, I couldn't mean any of you, gentlemen. Now, watch closely, watch closely. Take the ace of hearts and win the riches of the Indies. Now, I'm sure there must be a red-blooded sportsman among you who wouldn't mind stepping forward with a $10 bill in his hand. He will get the privilege of picking the magic ace of hearts and receiving as his reward the $100 bill. Now, step up here. Step up and see whether the hand is quicker than the eye.
It's a cent. That's the card there.
$10, a mere bagatelle, will prove.
If I'm right, do I get the $100?
Not only do you receive the cash award, you receive the secret of the trick, golden knowledge, which, if you were a lesser man, could reap you a golden harvest.
Hey.
Don't feel bad, my friends. The dishonest hand is quicker than the honest eye.
It's the woman this end. I've been watching closer.
Hey, and play. And now, my friends, that glittering dream of all true gamblers, a 10-to-1 payoff on a surety.
Hey, mister, that's my bet. Man, back feet, I was just reaching for my pocket. Here. That convinces me.
Then we can go?
Yes, out of town on a rail. Oh, now, just a minute, my good friends. I am going to show you how it works, where the elusive ace of hearts reposes. And it's to your advantage to know because you have it. And the man who has the ace of hearts receives the $100 bill.
I've got it.
Where is it? Now, watch closely, gentlemen. Watch closely. You just give me a little bit of room here, please. You'll be amazed when I show you where it is. You'll be astounded. You'll regard it as the miracle of the century. Start reaching, sucker.
As he explores the African savanna, encountering danger, adventure, honor.
What are you trying to do? Kill that man?
Romance.
It's a love song.
Cows in a love song?
You see, here in Africa, the natives use cows in place of money. And seven cows will buy a wife.
Do you suppose your father would be interested in some cows?
And some really angry warriors.
Tell him to take his boogeymen and clear out of here, or I'll make big magic that'll send them all to their happy hunting grounds.
Chief say, make big magic.
Okay.
Join John Calvert and Cornell and John Calvert.
What are you guarding around here? Here, take Becky to Becky.
As they discover the curse of the elephant's graveyard.
It's a deal.
Thank you.
I've had the privilege of touring around the world longer than any other magic show. We were first sponsored by General Motors, a Chevrolet General Motors, in 1934. Our show has run twice as long as any other magic show. And one reason is that I've been able to keep fit for that long. And in order to keep fit, you must lead a life without indulgence in things that destroy your health.
He says he's booked into the Palladium, and he's never lied to me, at his 100th birthday, which is only a couple of years away.
So what we try to do is to entertain the people, make them laugh, make them forget their troubles. I think it's necessary to make the audience like you.
Oh,